Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Hatter Adults. In this new video of this year, I'll show you how I do Yuji Itadori from Jujutsu Kaisen. I announced this project at the beginning of last year when I made this video, and well, there were some delays, bigger projects like the one of the doll of Bayonetta, which had set me a lot behind this one. And well, the time has come to do it starting this year 2022. As always, I share the character's concept art on my Instagram and for the first time on the YouTube community feature, giving Yuji my personal touches regarding what his reprint is going to be. Also, as an innovation for this year, I announced that I got a new tripod, which means that my video will have a better angle when I'm recording. This was the tripod I used in my previous videos, which to be honest, it was very uncomfortable to use. But now that I had this, recording the process will be more comfortable. So now that you know it, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and ring the bell to get notified when I apply new videos. And without more to say, let's get started. Oh, I forgot that I also have another innovation for this year. I'm not going to use this as a work table anymore, since I have replaced it with this cutting mat which I bought last year. To make Yuji, I will use one of the BTS dolls, which will be the B doll, since I really like how his facial and body proportions look. The first thing, as always, will be to remove the head in order to remove the hair and the face. With the head already out of its body, I will use my scissors to cut the hair near to the roots and thus continue cleaning the inside. Now with pure acetone, I clean the face of the doll. I had to do it by force, since it is a big problem to clean the faces of these BTS dolls. And this is how the face of the doll looks. I think I spent about like 5 cloths to make it look like this. This time I decided to reroute the doll, since this year I want to get out of my comfort zone a bit when it comes to work. Now with that done, it's time to grab the hair, and I'll do it using this pink jar that you see here. I will use a large needle to grab the strips. I grab the needle in one of the holes. With some pliers, I pull the needle from the head and remove it. Then I tie a knot and cut the excess. And push the thread back, remaining this way grafted and without using glue to ensure it. With that, I will continue to fill the spaces in pink, staying like this, very voluminous only in that area. With a pet brush, I managed to reduce the balloon a bit, although now it looks like a troll looking at it this way. With the help of a hair strainer, I will stretch it out and thus the balloon will decrease. And this is how Yuji's hair is after ironing it. It is not ready yet because I have to cut it. For the moment, I will leave it like that since now I'm gonna make his uniform. And for that, I will use this dark blue fabric, which is perfect for the uniform. As you can see, I already marked it and cut the part on top of it, and then I will sew the pieces. This is how they look now that I sew them. The next thing to work on will be the slits. To make the red part that protrudes from them, I will use a red ribbon, which I cut the same size as the slits and which I then sew it with thread. With that, I will sew them to the uniform. Staying in this way, it is time to close the piece as I'm pointing out. And this is how it has been. What I like about this fabric is that it's kinda elastic, which makes it easier to use. Making the hoodie was the most difficult, since drawing the form was too complicated. I looked for image for the anime and some cosplayers for a better reference, and nothing. So I start exploring on Pinterest, and it turns out that Yuji's hoodie is kinda like a ski mountaineer. So I look for more reference, and it gave me this result, which satisfies me a lot. But seriously, it was very stressful to do that. I also used the same fabric to be able to make his pants. And this is how the uniform looks on the doll's body. I must say that I really liked this result when I saw it all together. Off camera, I made the bottom of his uniform with a Patsy skull, and I also sculpted each one of them the spiral design that they have marked. And this is how they look with paint. The spiral has been more or less, but well, I couldn't do so much since I painted over something very small. I just had to glue the bottoms in their respective positions, and I will have the finished uniform top. For the shoes, I will use the same ones that came with the doll, since they are quite similar to those of the character due to the shape. The first thing I will do is paint them with a layer of red. And with black paint, I will make the decoration. Finishing protecting them with a layer of matte varnish. And this is how they look. They look so good that I even want to have some for myself. And seeing them differently, they look like the shoes of Deku from My Hero Academia. For final touches, off camera I made him the black stocking that he wears under his uniform. And the red shirt that he wears inside for, you know, details. With the uniform finished, it's time to repaint his face. I'm sorry to say that the head I was going to use has been damaged due to the reroute, and it bothers me a lot, as the time I spent on it has been wasted. So I can use this. Luckily, I have a spare head from the same doll, and it is the one I'm going to use for the repaint. Already with the head on his body, I sprayed 3 layers of MSC to be able to draw the lines of his eyes. I must say that it was not easy to record this part with the new tripod, and more because the heads of the BTS dolls are very small. To make Itadori's face, I based it completely on my concept, since his original design was not going to fit well in this type of mold. And every time I draw a concept, I always base it on the proportion of the doll that I will use for a certain project. It's simple, and so I don't have to improvise. Now with the pencil, I will draw the lines that represent Sukuna's eyes, trying to do it very carefully. With that, I will continue to fill it with more colors. With chalk pastels, I will give it a bit of realism to the face, although I must say which also works as a good suntan lotion. Somehow the red pencil has helped me to highlight the lines that I draw, as well as using other shades of color like the brown pencil. With that, I will use the black pencil to highlight the eyelashes and the other lines. With the watercolor moistened in a brush, I highlight the white parts more. Finishing that, I will highlight more the face with acrylic paint. And this is how Yuji's face looks after having painting over it. I'm very happy to give my personal touch to his face, and it is something that I will continue doing in future videos. This was the varnish that I used in my repaints, and unfortunately it also has been damaged due to the temperature. Thank God I was able to replace it with this Mod Podge gloss varnish. All I must do is pass it over to the eyes, other part of his face, and it's done. After the disaster, I went through with the reroute. I had no choice but to make a wig with the hairs I had grafted on the other head. I was not in the mood to feel this part because of what happened, so I worked on it off camera. Accidents happen, and I think the result has been better this way. The position of the hands of the BTS dolls are very rigid, and I don't feel they are very appropriate for Yuji. So I decided to change the position, as you can see. I've seen Hetsuchan do it in one of his videos, but never with one of these dolls. I only know that he used hot and cold water to be able to change the position, and I must say that it really works. This result has seriously blown me away. I'm thinking of making a video tutorial of this or showing it in my next repaint. So I'll put it as a poll in the community feature so you guys can vote and give me your opinion. With a potsy skull, I modified one of the hands to make Sukuna's mouth, since I want Yuji to have something much more characteristic of the cursed spirit inside him, based on the cover of the volume 1 of the manga. So what I will do next will be to give it touches with paint so that it can blend it better with the hand. And this is how it looks. The varnish that I put on his tongue has seriously given an excellent touch. I took two more hands and I also positioned them by giving them a few touches of blush. I tried to make the last two look like fits, but I could only achieve something like that. But in the end, the result has been wonderful. And for the first time on the channel, I will show you how I assemble everything to the body of the doll. And with that, Yuji Itadori is ready. To be the first video of the year, it was quite stressful to work with. This is the second time I working with one of these BTS dolls, and it was very challenging. Although I must admit that I can achieve excellent results like this, making anime boys with this kind of proportions. Thanks for watching this video, I hope you enjoy it. Remember to subscribe to my channel to see more content like this, and also follow me on my other social media. Last week it was my birthday, so if you want to congratulate me in the comments, you are welcome to do so. My name is Eric, and I will see you next time. Bye!